What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about setting up Splunk Universal Forwarder on Windows. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about getting some data within our Splunk server using the Universal Forwarder that Splunk has. So I'm not going to go over how to download the Universal Forwarder. It's, you know, if you signed up to their portal and you downloaded the server edition, most likely the option to download the Universal Forwarder is there. So I'm not going to go over that. So what we need to do is log into our Splunk server, which I'm already logged into my Splunk server. And on the upper right-hand side, we're going to click on settings. Within settings, underneath data, we're going to click on forwarding and receiving. So click on it, go for it. There we go. Underneath receive data, for configure receiving, we need to click on add new, and we need to enter our TCP port. Now the TCP port, which is the default one for Splunk, is 9997. So that is what I'm going to enter. Make sure that you have your firewall, your, you know, group policies, whatever you're using, configured properly for this port to listen throughout your network. We're going to click save here. It is saved. Now I'm going to head over to a server that I want to, you know, event logs to go over to my Splunk so I can analyze it. And that will be my SCOM server. Within my SCOM server, I already downloaded the Splunk Universal Forwarder MSI file, and I actually dropped it into my downloads folder. And I open up my downloads folder, and there goes the MSI. I'm going to right-click on it. We're going to select install. It's going to start preparing to install, and eventually you're going to get the wizard. We're going to check off. Check this box to accept the license agreement. Once you do that, let's click on next. Provide a username and uncheck generate a random password and provide a password and confirm the password. Now, this password is for your administrative account for the Universal Forwarder on this machine, okay, for the client. We're going to click next here. It is time for us to enter our deployment server. You could enter the full qualified domain name of your Splunk server or the IP address. I entered the IP address as well as the port, which would be 9997, because that is what we entered within our Splunk portal, our Splunk server. We're going to click next here. Now for the receiving indexer, I enter the same thing. You could do the host name or the IP. I did the IP as well as the port of 9997, and then click next. Click install. Give it some time. You're going to get the user account control. So click yes here, and it is going to start installing. Give it some time, and we're done. It's pretty quick, pretty simple. We're going to click finish here. And we need to head over to our Splunk server. So head over to your Splunk server and open up the portal. This is where we left off. And from here on the upper right-hand side, we're going to click on settings. And underneath data, we're going to click on data inputs. So click on it. Now within here, we're going to locate UDP. And once you locate UDP, we're going to click on add new. So go for it, click on it. And it's time for us to enter our port. Now, the port that I enter for our UDP would be the following, 9997. I'm going to click on next, which is located at the very top. For our source type, I'm going to select new. For our source type, as well as our source type description, I gave it the following. The type is going to be win event log. And the description is basically the IP address of my SCOM server. I'm going to scroll down, and within the index section, I'm going to click on create a new index that is a hyperlink. So go for it, click on it. And for the index name, I'm going to give it the following, win underscore log. We're going to click on save. And at the very top, we're going to click on review. This is our review. The type UDP, the port 9997, the source type, win event log, app context is a launcher, the host IP address or the remote server, and the index is win_log. At the very top, we're going to click on submit. So go for it, click on it. And done. Our UDP import has been created successfully, which is awesome. We are able to click on start searching, which you are able to do that. Just give it some time. Eventually, I just went to lunch, and when I came back, I refreshed the page, or I think it timed out on me and I had to re-log back in. So I re-logged back into my Splunk Enterprise portal. And within the portal right here on the dashboard, I clicked on search your data. So click on it and it's going to take you here. So enter a search. So I enter the following, right? And once I hit the lollipop or hit enter, the lollipop is a little magnifier to search. I like to call it the lollipop because it looks like a lollipop. You're able to hit enter, but once you hit enter, it's going to actually give you all the content, which is great. Again, it takes some time for this information to grab from whatever server you install the universal forwarder agent to get pulled from that server over to the Splunk. But eventually, you're going to see all this information, which is great. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.